An analyst has congratulated the MK Party for their performance, saying that the MK Party has done extremely well. In an article shared by EIOL, I want us to go through that article. Really, it was written by Uthabo Makwakwa. Right, released on the 22nd of September 2024. We'll talk about that. And then let's talk about Supra Mahomapilo. There is a need for ANC to go through what they call it a renewal, right? ANC needs a real renewal. At least that's not what I say, but that's what Supra Mahomapilo has said. Mamunaledi Pando. Yes, Mamunaledi Pando. She has been appointed as the chairperson of Nelson Mandela Foundation. Chairperson or board member between the two. But wait a minute. I've got it here. Right? Nelson Mandela Foundation released a statement on the 23rd of September 2024, saying media statement foundation appoints a new chair for its board. So she's a chairperson for the board in Nelson Mandela Foundation. So kudos. Let's read what the foundation says. The board of trustees of the Nelson Mandela Foundation is delighted to announce the appointment of its new chair, Dr. Naledi Pando. Dr. Pando will become only the third person to hold the position since Nelson Mandela established the organization in 1999, when Professor Jake Gawal became the founding incumbent. Begins on the 1st of October 2024. Okay? Wait. We'll talk about Supra Mahomapilo. Le and Northwest. Speaking about ANC renewal. We'll definitely have time to speak about all these other political parties here, and also speak about a lot of things here. I think we should proceed talking about the appointment follows the retirement of board chair Professor Njabulo Ndebele, who has served on the board for a quarter of a century, serves as a chair for over a decade. In announcing his successor, Prof. Ndebele said, Dr. Pando offers the foundation just what it needed for the next phase of its own development. I wish her every success in the role. On his own retirement, Prof. Ndebele commented, "It is time for me to step away and make way for fresh leadership and embark on a new phase of my life journey." Wait. New member in the Nelson Mandela Foundation, Supra Mahomapilo. Somebody praises ANC. There's more that is still coming up. So you dare not leaving this YouTube channel right now. You need to watch until the end. But yay! There is something that needs to be done. Before then, do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contributing to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying?
we'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay. Let's proceed. Starting here. The board and staff on the Nelson Mandela Foundation are immensely grateful for Prof. Ndebele for his many years of impeccable service for the wise counsel he always brought to the role. Acting Chief Executive Professor Vane Harris added, "Prof. Ndebele has been a compass to us through good and bad time." Dr. Pando worked closely with Madiba during South African's first democratic administration in 1990s and is one of the South African's longest serving member of parliament. She has served in numerous leadership roles with distinction, the most recent being that of international relations minister. I am both honored and delighted to be entrusted with this role, said Dr. Naledi Pando. In a world facing so many complex challenges, mobilizing Madiba's legacy becoming more important than ever. I believe that the Nelson Mandela Foundation is doing critically important work in social justice space, and I'm looking forward to making a meaningful contribution. Both Dr. Pando and Professor Ndebele will be attending the 22nd Nelson Mandela annual lecture later this week in what will be a ceremonial handing over of the baton. The lecture will be delivered by Nobel Prize winner that is what I have for you so far as Dr. Naledi Pando is concerned. Now, Suprema Homapilo, before we get into the one year MK party, Suprema Homapilo, in an article released by IOL, written by Usipo Chek, this is what they say. This is important because developmentism differs from one country to another based on its own circumstances. That is why a country such as China believes in socialism, but socialism with Chinese characteristics. The broad consultation to review the Freedom Charter will not only assist in ensuring active citizens, but ensure that the ultimate final document, SA Freedom Charter for a Development Start, is something that all society can own, internalize, collectively implement, defend, review. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, but the long and short of it is that he's speaking about the fact that ANC, there needs to be a renewal in the ANC. Yeah, there needs to be a renewal in the ANC. There's an analyst who praised MK Party despite the challenges and despite what other people are saying. Let's get into the analyst. The analyst goes by the name of Dr. Mechi Makgoba. He said, the formation of MK Party in 2023, becoming the third biggest political party in South Africa after the elections, has disrupted the country's political landscape, but also invited internal problems that needed to be carefully managed, said independent political analyst and senior lecturer at the University of Limpopo. I've already told you who's that. Their swift actions are commendable. if they make their decision based on principles, traditions, of issues management, they will continue doing it. There is a wrong belief that democracy is an acceptable system of governance. That is a lie, and MK Party should continue making decisions that benefit its growth. If they want to be autocratic and have guidelines for their processes, that is fine. Democratic processes have collapsed. Many parties and organizations. However, the main issue is that they may spend more time in court to defend their decisions if they are not allowed, because there are no proper guidelines to tackle disputes. Internal battles were inevitable because MK Party is made of comrades who could not find expression in other parties, such as the African National Congress and the Economic Freedom Fighter. Some of those comrades are opportunistic and will always seem to infiltrate the party. Okay. Uti, this concern is very authentic and MK Party should address it. Having gender balance is necessary to address the concerns that affect all people. If the party is intentional about being male dominated, it will experience decline and will be limited in terms of development. Okay? That's at least what a professor here has got to say. Maybe let me read this last part. I thought I was gonna be the end, but let me read this part. Okay. This includes ensuring that it's all infiltrated by agent. Okay, let's leave this one. This one is not important that much. Yeah, it's not that important. What's your take about MK Party and their performance? For me personally, I think they've done well. For me personally, I think they've done quite well. I don't falter them. Nobody gave them a chance. And I remember talking to a lot of people. People thought that, nah, this thing is going to die. But look at where MK Party is today. So yeah, for me, I kind of felt like, I think it's a good idea that we have a MK party. It's a very, 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 very great idea. Not only is this a good idea that we have MK party, but the way they're going about everything. It's so interesting. For me, what I love about EMK Party is the fact that they are very intentional about a lot of things that they are doing, and they take time to do certain things, right? Despite pressure, despite anything, the type of leaders that they want to bring on board, they are bringing people that are well experienced, which is one of the things that can sustain the political party going forward. You need people who are experienced. Yes, that's the word I was looking for. You need experienced individuals. And so MK Party, they are indeed trying by all means necessary to get that experience that is needed to the party. So again, yeah, looking at how they are going about everything, I'm impressed. Honestly, I'm very, 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 very impressed. What else am I also checking? I think, Super Mahomapelo. Yeah, I think let's entertain that. Super Mahomapelo becoming a member of a board member. What's your take about that? I thought that was also interesting. Eh? Now she's going to be serving on Mandela Foundation as the chairperson there. What's your take? The other one is relatively... Oh, is it relative to this one? the fact that they are saying that Super Mahomapelo is speaking about the renewal of the ANC and how they need to go about it because it is necessary. It's not even a thing that they want. It's not even a want in the ANC. It's a need. They need to. There's a need for them to get to something called renewal. What do you think about, or what's your take about all of that? Me and you, we need to talk. And we can only do that in the comment section below. So I'll see you on the next episode. But until such a time, please take care.